He's in very good hands. The British Foreign Minister praised the NHS as he entered Downing Street, filling in for the absent Prime Minister.
He remains stable overnight. He's receiving standard oxygen treatment and breathing without any assistance. He's not required any mechanical ventilation or non-invasive respiratory support.
With Boris Johnson still in intensive care, Dominic Raab is deputising, although there are some limits to his powers.
Dominic Raab is going to be in charge of the day-to-day decisions, though he's going to have to do that with the cabinet. So he couldn't, for example, go into a reshuffle, start forging his own path on Brexit, that he happens to agree with the Prime Minister very much on Brexit. He has to follow, really, the decisions that Boris Johnson has laid down.
Johnson was admitted to hospital on Sunday for tests after suffering symptoms including a cough and a temperature for over a week following his coronavirus diagnosis. But his condition deteriorated and on Monday he was moved to an intensive care unit. According to British authorities, the Prime Minister is in a stable condition and remains conscious. He's been given oxygen but hasn't been put on a ventilator. But British medical experts say his condition is likely to be serious.
The NHS, particularly at this moment, doesn't give up intensive care beds just for people to be looked over. It doesn't work like that, even for prime ministers. He wouldn't be in intensive care unless he needed to be in intensive care.
The prime minister's absence leaves the government shaken as it prepares to tackle the worst of the coronavirus epidemic so far.